We're asked to translate and dilate the unit circle to map it onto each circle. So this is the unit circle right over here. It's centered at 0, 0. It has a radius of 1. That's why we call it a unit circle. And when they say translate, they say move it around. So that would be a translation of it. And then dilating it means making it larger. So dilating that unit circle would be doing, whoops, I just translated it, would be doing something like that. So we're gonna translate and dilate this unit circle to map it onto each circle. So for example, I can translate it so that the center is translated to the center of that magenta circle, and then I can dilate it so that it has been mapped onto that larger magenta circle. I can do that, let me do it for a few more. I'm not gonna do it for all of them, just to give you the idea of what they're talking about. So now I'm translating the center of my, it's no longer a unit circle, I'm translating the center of my circle to the center of the purple circle, and now I'm gonna dilate it so it has the same radius, and notice, I can map it. And so if you can map one shape to another through translation and dilation, then the things are, by definition, they are going to be similar. So this is really just an exercise in seeing that all circles are similar. If you just take any circle and you make it have the same center as another circle, then you can just scale it. You can just scale it up or down to match the circle that you moved it to the center of. So there you have it. Hopefully this gives you a sense that all circles are similar.